You will often hear about databases in academic libraries. Library databases are an important resource for researchers, both student and professional, and understanding how they work will make your library research in the future easier and more productive. So what is a library database? Well, a database is just a searchable collection of information. We use different kinds of databases every day. Apple's iTunes is a database of songs to buy. Amazon.com is a huge database of products for sale. Even your cell phone includes a database of family and friends' names and phone numbers. Library databases are collections of magazine and newspaper articles, book chapters, conference proceedings, and other kinds of digitized research material. Because library databases can contain the content of up to thousands of different journal titles, they're a great place to do your research. Different library databases contain different kinds of content. Some databases only include articles for a particular subject area. An example of a subject-specific database is CINAHL with full text. CINAHL, or the Cumulative Index to Nursing and Allied Health Literature, contains the full text to over 600 different nursing and allied health-related journals. Naturally, the CINAHL database would be a poor place to find English literature or physics articles, but would be excellent for nursing or other health-related programs like massage therapy or nutrition. NCLive.org contains the bulk of the databases available to you at Carteret Community College. NCLive organizes its databases into subject categories. So for example, if you are writing a current issues or pro-con paper, you could select the current issues category and find a list of current issue-related databases. Some databases contain only certain formats of material. Newspaper Source Plus contains hundreds of reputable newspapers, but only newspapers, no journals, no book chapters. Net Library contains only ebooks. So be aware not only of a database's subject area, but also of the kinds of material formats it contains. Finally, some databases are multidisciplinary. This means that a single database might cover many different subject areas. These large multidisciplinary databases are often the best first stop when doing library research. Academic Search Premier is a multidisciplinary database. You'll find articles in Academic Search Premier on a wide variety of topics, from political science and psychology to English literature and the sciences. Many experienced student researchers start their research in Academic Search Premier, whatever course that they're in at the time. Before you begin a database search, select any limiters that you'd like to use. Limiters filter out content that you know in advance that you don't need. So for example, do you need articles only from a particular date range? There's a limiter for that, which will weed out articles outside that particular range. Only interested in scholarly articles? Mark off that limiter, and all but scholarly articles will be weeded out of your search. While different databases may look different, the tools are all generally pretty similar. One especially important limiter is for full text. Even though databases contain hundreds, sometimes thousands of different full-text journals, many will also contain article records where the full text is not available. By marking off the full-text limiter, you weed out those citations or abstract-only records. Now you'll have full and immediate access to all of the articles in your search returns. Finding the right database to search in is only the first step. You'll also need to come up with thoughtful search terms. We'll cover that in a future module. Remember, if you have any questions about doing research, ask a librarian.